GitHub is a website that makes it easy to share an entire Git repository with other people. For example, here's a repository that we've created at Udacity. This repository is the source for a browser-based create your own adventure story. Here are all the files in the repository. I can click around and navigate the directory structure, and I can look at the commit history. If I go back to the main page and scroll down a little bit, I can see some information about the project. I can also directly view the contents of files, assuming that they're plain text like code or this story. GitHub also supports a couple of other formats for things like images, 3D models, and map data. In this file, I can click through to the story itself and start making some choices. You can always go back to the main page of the repository by clicking here. This is a public repository, so anybody can look at these contents and suggest changes. Caroline and I will go over how this works in detail in this lesson, and by the end of the lesson, you'll be able to contribute to it yourself. This is a living project, so by the time you visit this page, things might look a little bit different, but the basics will be the same. GitHub is the home of many public projects like this one. A lot of public projects are open source, meaning that you can copy and modify the code for your own purposes. GitHub also lets you suggest changes and send them back to the creator of the project. Some of these open source projects are pretty small and relatively unknown, like MathQuil, which only has 10 contributors. You might recognize this one. Some projects are much larger, like IPython, an interactive shell for Python that's nicer than the one you get by default. Another large project is Bootstrap, which is a framework that makes it easier to do web development. There's also jQuery, a JavaScript library that makes it easy to interact with HTML, and Atom, a text editor designed for editing code and allowing users to customize their experience. These are projects that anyone could theoretically contribute to, though of course any changes must be accepted by the people maintaining the project. But even if the original author chooses not to incorporate your changes, you can still keep your own version. GitHub aims to promote open source by allowing anyone to host public repositories for free and charging for private repositories. Many companies, including Udacity, use Git to keep track of changes to their proprietary code, and use GitHub to host a private copy of their repository and allow for easy code reviews when developers submit changes. For this lesson, you'll be interacting with GitHub a lot, creating, modifying, and suggesting changes to public repositories, so you'll need to set up an account. This is pretty straightforward, but you'll probably also want to get set up to smoothly interact with GitHub from the command line, which is a little bit more involved. You'll see instructions for how to get everything set up after this video.